Our Google Workspace Developer Relations team just held two more Google Workspace Developer Summits in Europe. The first was held in Amsterdam and the second in Zurich. In this video, you will see a short summary of all the sessions held at the summits. During his session, Matthew Izett, Lead Product Manager, Workspace Developer Ecosystem, highlighted the fact that 3 billion users worldwide utilize Google Workspace to help them be productive. More than 5 billion apps and add-ons have been installed from the Google Workspace Marketplace, extending the capabilities of the platform to help users do even more. As mentioned by Matt, developers can find success on the Workspace platform thanks to the huge audience they can reach. The platform provides a selection of tools from no-code to full-stack development to create solutions for Google Workspace and offer them in the Workspace Marketplace. The attendees heard of Google's plans to build AI-powered workflows across Google Workspace and third-party tools. Matt also shared the latest updates on GenAI integration partners and Duet AI in AppSheet, to name just a few. In Zurich, the attendees heard from David Lugrin, Product Manager Google Calendar, that the launch of the reading and writing of out-of-office and focus time events using the Calendar API would be announced the following day. Charles Maxson, Developer Advocate Google Workspace, spoke about why developers should consider building Google Chat apps. The many new features added to Google Chat in the past months have been a driving force in the uptake of users the instant messaging tool has seen. Earlier this year, we added the ability for consumer users with Gmail accounts to discover and use chat apps. We also added chat apps to the Google Workspace admin console so that admins can manage access to chat apps and install them for users across their organization. By the end of 2023, users will be able to search, discover, and install chat apps in the Google Workspace Marketplace directly from the Google Chat user interface. Charles suggested that developers can take an iterative approach in creating chat apps by leveraging the different tools that Google Workspace platform offers. For example, consider trying no-code and low-code tools like AppSheet and AppScript to explore building chat apps, and then move to full custom development on your own stack when you prove your use cases and features or see increased demand. Just days before the summit, the Google Chat Advanced Services for AppScript were launched, which will help streamline the creation of chat apps for developers. The attendees heard about two more features that will be added to chat apps by the end of 2023: app homepages and private messages. Make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel to learn more about these features once they launch. At both summit locations, Comin, a Google Workspace partner that helps create a seamless experience between people and workplaces, presented their app. The Comin Workspace Google Chat app sends check-in notifications to help users plan their in-office days. David Harcum, Partner Developer Advocate Google Workspace, spoke about how developers can extend Google Workspace through add-ons. Add-ons can be built either using AppScript or alternate runtimes. David spoke about the benefits of each technology and when to use which. Besides creating Google Workspace add-ons, developers can also build editor add-ons for Sheets, Docs, or Slides. To help developers choose the best option for their solution, David explained the differences between the add-on types and made recommendations on when to create the respective add-ons. The attendees were encouraged to publish their add-ons to the Google Workspace Marketplace, and they heard about the relevant best practices to help them do so. In Amsterdam, the attendees heard from Evgeny Mironenko, a software engineer, how Miro created their Google Workspace add-on. The attendees were excited to hear that the ability to extend the app menu in Docs will be coming to the developer preview program. In case you haven't already done so, sign up for the Developer Preview Program so that you can get early access to new features. Milo, Group Product Manager Google Workspace Meet Platform, spoke about how developers can integrate their apps and workflows with the Meet APIs and SDKs. The Google Meet REST API enables developers to create meetings and retrieve meeting information, while the Google Workspace Events API allows for the subscribing to meetings and to be notified with changes. The Google Meet SDK, which will launch in 2024, enables developers to add Meet capabilities into their apps. This means the user isn't only able to start a Google Meet from a third-party app, they are also able to participate in Meet without ever leaving the third-party app. Ken Stanarelli, technical writer, Google Workspace ME platform, walked attendees through how they can get started using the Google Meet API and how they can build a Google Meet add-on. Steve Basil, head of developer relations, Google Workspace, and Justin Ponelt, developer relations engineer, Google Workspace, held a deep dive session about authentication and authorization for Google Workspace platform. The two looked up four common scenarios for Google Workspace development and how auth works for each. You can watch Steve's session from Google Cloud Next 23, linked in the description below, to learn more about this topic. Charles walked the attendees through a tutorial to build a GenAI solution with Google Workspace. The solution combines an interactive chat app, the chat API, and generative AI using the Google Vertex AI API to automate how a support team can leverage Google Chat to manage and collaborate reported service incidents. Find the link to the tutorial in the description so that you can work through this tutorial yourself. The team behind Folgo showed how they are leveraging Google Chat and GenAI to help organizations manage Google Drive. Of course, there was ample time for the attendees to network, exchange ideas, and more. Make sure to sign up to this YouTube channel where we will be announcing future Google Workspace Developer Summits.